Hello everyone, welcome back to the Power BI tutorials. In this video, we will see two very important concepts of Power BI, and these concepts are known as drill through and the slicers in Power BI. Now, both of these concepts are used for the purpose of filtering the data on the visuals. And how they are different from the traditional filters that we have already seen, it is what we are going to discuss in this video. So let us start. First of all, I have opened up my Power BI, but this is a new sheet. So I can just go to file and open this file 03, which is the existing file in which we have worked out on the previous videos. Okay. So it may take a few seconds to open up. In the meantime, let us just discuss that what is drill through. So drill through is kind of a filter which is applied over multiple visuals that could span through multiple pages. Right now, what we have seen is that how can we apply filters over a simple or a single visual. Now we are going to see that how can we actually apply or select some value in a visual that is present in one page, and how will it be applied over the visual present on the second page. Okay, so we are basically going to connect the two visuals present in different pages and apply filters with the help of drill through. So for that purpose, what we are going to do first of all is a simple thing. Let us just create a bar chart and let us open up our orders table. Now in the orders table we have different things, and one of them is known as region. So what we are going to do actually is we are going to just make use of this region thing. We just scroll down. So here is this region. We are going to drag this region into this access field, and the values it is going to be of sales. So sales will be dragged in on the values. Okay, so what we have got in our bar chart over here is the region wise sales of the different items right here. Okay, now this is what is a simple bar chart. What we are going to do next is, in a separate page, we are going to create a visual. We are going to actually create a pie chart. Okay, and in this also we are going to add region and we are going to add sales. Okay, so right now what is happening is we are getting all the four regions and how many sales were done in all those four regions. Okay, so this is a simple approach how you can work with it. Now with the help of drill through, what we can do is we can actually just use this kind of the bar chart that we created. We can select any kind of region from there, and only the value of that particular region will be shown over here in this pie chart, or vice versa. That is, we can just select any region from the pie chart over here, and that corresponding sales value will only be shown over the bar chart. So what we can do is, first of all, we need to go to that particular visual and that particular page which we want to filter. Okay, so we want to filter the values of the bar chart. So we need to just select this bar chart. In the visualizations pane, there is something written as drill through. So you need to go to that. Just scroll down and you will see there is an option called add drill through fields here. So we need to add the fields through which we want to do the drilling. So the field is going to be the region field. So you need to just select this field and bring it over here in the region column. Okay, so that is it. But right now you cannot see any change. How you can just see the change? You can just go to page 7 where our pie chart is residing. Now what you can do is, if you just hover over any of these options, you can see east, region is given, sales is given, and another option, that is right click to drill through, is also given. Now this option ensures that actually we can right click on any of the options, any of the regions over here, and we will be able to drill through them. Why? Because we have added region as a drill through field in that bar chart. Okay. So if you want to drill through, what you got to do? Suppose I want to drill through south. So I can just right click over here simply, and I will get this option of drill through. When I expand it, there is the name of the page, that is page 6, where the bar chart is present. So as soon as I click on page 6, then what happens? In an instant, I get to page 6. This bar chart is now only having this south as the value. There is no other value present. Only the sales of the south region are shown to me. So this is the advantage of drilling through. Actually, the main thing about drilling through is that it helps you to create links between the visuals present in different pages. But now what happens if you want to do similar thing like drilling through, but in the same page or on the visuals that are present in the same page? For that purpose, we have something known as slicers in Power BI. So let's see, how can we create slicers? Let us just create a new page, that is going to be page 8. And what we are going to do is, actually we are going to create a table. Okay, we are going to create a table over here. And what values are we going to add? We are going to add region. We are going to add sales, that is region wise sales. We would get this data. And we are going to add like quantity. Okay. So let us just expand this table. So this table or this data, this visual tells us that in which region how many sales were done and how many orders were placed in that particular region. Okay. Now if I just sort it out on the basis of sales, that is in the east region maximum sales were done, in the south region minimum sales were done. So that's a simple approach. Now what I can do is I can just add a slicer. So this is a slicer. Its icon is present just beside the table icon in the visualizations pane. You can simply click on it. What this slicer will do is it will just hold the different types of values. You can add fields in the slicer, and it would hold these fields. As soon as you add the slicer, it is connected to the table. Whatever field you select in the slicer, it would be this table would be just filtered according to that particular field. So suppose this is the field option of the slicer. If we add like say region over here, then what happens is in this slicer we get four things, that is the four regions, central, east, south and west, along with a checkbox. If I want to show only the value of the east region, then you can see this table is filtered itself. Only the east region values are shown. If you want to show the only for the south region, only south region values are shown. Similarly, any of the regions you can work upon. But if you want to show more than one value of the region, you can simply just control click on that particular region, and then two values would be visible. Like just control click. So east is visible now and south is visible. But there are obviously some of the modifications that are possible on a slicer. How can you do that modifications? You can just go to this format tab of the slicer, and here is the selection controls option. If you just turn this multi-select with control option off, then what happens is you are able to select these multiple options once again. Like if you just uncheck all, now none of them are selected. If you just click on south, then the south is shown. Now if we click on west, then both south and west options are shown. So this is how you can just go with multi-select. But if you do not want to go with multi-select, you can just go to again the selection controls option, and you can make sure this single select is turned on. Now this all turns into the radio buttons, which means you can only select one option from the list of the available options. Now you can either select south region, west region, east region or the central region. Okay. So this was for about the text data. That is, we had this text data in the slicer. Let us just delete the slicer, and our table would be restored to all of the values. Now what we are going to do is create a quantity slicer. That is, for this quantity, we are going to create a slicer. So let us just again bring up a slicer. And now instead of a region, we are going to drag our quantity in this field. So let's just click on this quantity, and we have got this quantity over here. Okay. Now this quantity is between 1 to 167, that is because it is for the orders, not on the basis of the region. So basically what I wanted to tell you is, if we just use the slider, this is a slider that is available in a number or in any of the quantities that we get, so we will be able to get the filtering of this slicers with the help of this slider. Like, you can just select any of those values and the corresponding values would be filtered. So this is how the slicer works. We have seen the text slicer, we have also seen the quantity slicer or the numerical slicer. That's all about the filters in Power BI, and thanks for watching.